My name is Kate Crowley, Professor of Practice here at Teachers College, Columbia University in New York City. Welcome to the Cleft Palate Speech and Feeding video tutorials that I've created with my co-authors, Dr. Miriam Baigorri and Ms. Chelsea Sommer. This is module 3.6, where we look at the speech therapy hierarchy, and it will be done by my friend and colleague, bilingual speech language pathologist, Diana Acevedo.
My name is Diana Acevedo. I'm a bilingual speech language pathologist with extensive experience with craniofacial and cleft lip and palate. I have a private practice in the South Florida area, and I have also had the opportunity to work with Dr. Crowley and to travel internationally in projects related to cleft lip and palate. I'm going to walk you through the speech therapy hierarchy. We're going to start with discrimination. Here we want to make sure that the child understands what is the incorrect speech pattern and what is it that we want them to produce correctly. Here's an example of discrimination.
That one is b, b. Yeah, now listen again, ready? B, b. Yes. Listen again. Ma, ma. Yes.
Then you're going to work on the target sound in isolation, making sure that the child can produce this sound in isolation. And here's a great example of how to work on this sound in isolation.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll go first?
Yeah.
Woo! One more. Very nice.
Next, you will work on the target sound in syllables, and we recommend using the Acevedo spoke to target the sound in syllables, focusing again on a variety of syllable structures. VC, CV, VC, C, CV, CV. Here's an example of how to use the Acevedo spoke and work on syllables.
We use the Acevedo spoke to teach the sound in syllables. Here we're going to demonstrate how to use the Acevedo spoke to teach sounds and syllables. The target sound here is S, and we could work on S in different syllable sequences. Consonant vowel, vowel consonants, vowel consonant vowel, consonant vowel consonant vowels. Daniela, we're going to be working on the s. We've been working on the s for a while now, and you can say your s, the s in isolation, all by itself. Can you try it? Just use your finger. Good. Now we're going to work on the s in syllables, so we're going to put it together. We're going to go sa, sa. Good. Say,
say,
see,
see,
so,
so,
sue,
sue.
Good job. Okay, so now we're gonna go, us,
say,
s, oh, remember, us,
us.
Good, making that S, S,
S,
is,
is.
Okay, let's try that one again. Go back to this one. S,
S,
is,
is.
Us,
us.
Good, making the S, us,
us.
Okay, now we're gonna try asa. Esse.
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 Oso.
Oso.
Usu.
Usu.
Good. Now let's try this. Sa, sa.
Sa, sa.
Se, se.
Se, se.
Si, si.
Si, si.
So, so.
so, so.
Su, su.
Su, su.
Good job.
Then we're going to work on the target sound at the word level. We want to make sure that the child is able to produce the sound in the initial, medial, and final position of words. At leadersproject.org, you could find word list with the target sounds. Also, you could download for free different board games to work at this level. These games target specific sounds. All of the other sounds in the words are low-pressured sounds and nasal sounds and vowels that are easy for children with cleft lip and palate to produce. These games are fun for the children to practice, and they're also easy for the parents to use at home for home practice. Here's an example of a P word game. You can see it's a board game with different words with the P sound combined with low pressure and nasal sounds that are easy for children with cleft lip and palate to produce. Here's an example of a K word game, again containing only K sounds with low pressure and nasal sounds. Here's an example of a G or a G word game. Here you'll find an example of an S word game. Here is an example of a word game with the ng to facilitate K and G sounds. Once the child has mastered the sounds at the word level, move on to phrases and sentences. Start with short phrases and then move on to full sentences. You can use books from leadersproject.org that focus on different cognate pairs. These books are unique because they target specific cognate pairs combined with low-pressured sounds, nasal sounds, and vowels that are easy for children with cleft palate to produce.
Benny piled up.
Benny piled up.
A bilby.
A bilby.
A boar.
A boar.
A bull.
A bull.
A puma.
A puma.
And a brown bear.
And a brown bear.
Mum, me. Mum, me. Mum, mum, mum.
I didn't like
that. Try
that
one again.
Yeah.
Bop, bop, bop.
Map, map, map.
Nice.
Good. Just try to pronounce the word as clearly as you can, okay? Take your time. Pale.
Pale in L well. Pull, penny, pull. Pull, pull, pull. A baboon.
A baboon.
That was pretty.
One of the English books focuses on P's and B's, Penny and Benny, pull, pull, pull. Another book focusing on the B and P is Bumblebee, Bumblebee. Here's an English cleft palate book focusing on the T and D, Ted and Todd, a toad tail. Here you'll find another English cleft palate book focusing on the S and the Z, the smelly Sue. At leadersproject.org, you could also find Spanish cleft palate books such as El Pollo Pepe, que se enfoca en el pa y el ba. You can also find French cleft palate books, Mandarin cleft palate books, Korean cleft palate books, Amharic cleft palate book, which is a language spoken in Ethiopia, Tri cleft palate book, which is the language spoken in Ghana, Ibu cleft palate books, which is the language spoken in Nigeria. Once the child has mastered the target sound at the phrase and sentence level, move on to conversation. You want to make sure that the child is able to pull all those skills you worked on during conversation and connected speech. Here's an example on how to target the sound at the conversational level.
Let me hear that again. I open the door with a key.
I open the door with a key.
Nope.
Now you did
key.
That's key.
It's okay.
You just gotta do like this.
Key.
Key.
Yeah.
Try it again. So do the whole thing.
I open.
I open
a door with a key.
Oh.
Key. I open a door with a key.
Oh. That was great.
That's my girl.
Once the child has mastered all the different levels of the hierarchy, pick a new sound and begin the hierarchy again. Remember, when choosing the next target sound, make sure that it's developmentally appropriate. Also, start by working on voiceless cognate, such as p, and then on the voice cognate, such as buh. Caution clinicians, always consider developmentally appropriate speech targets. Remember, the client must be able to produce a sound with 100% accuracy at one stage before moving on to the next stage in the hierarchy. Also remember that voiceless sounds are usually easier to target than their voice cognates. For example, target p before b. This concludes the end of module 3.6. Next, in module 3.7, we will discuss why oral motor exercises do not work. If you're just joining us, you can find this module along with all the rest at leadersproject.org.